Alright, everyone. And I'm back. Sorry about that. So yeah, I hope that made sense. I hope the desktop dungeon stream made sense. I feel like I didn't explain things well enough, and at the same time, I kind of over-explained things. Kosh just says, the devs wanted a game to take 10 to 15 minutes to complete, but instead a game takes around 40 to 50 minutes. Usually it does take about 15 to 20 minutes. It took way longer because I was kind of explaining everything. This is going, right? Yeah, okay. I should probably trust it when I hit the hotkey, but I always feel in the back of my mind, like, is it really going? I can't tell. So yeah, that was Desktop Dungeons. This is Rogue Legacy. This is going to be kind of blind. I've never actually played this game before. I have watched playthroughs, of course. And it's going to be a little weird since I'm not using an Xbox controller, and all of the button prompts are mapped to Xbox controller buttons. I'm actually using a PS2 controller with an adapter. So, circle is the jump button, and then triangle is the attack button. I should probably just get a damn Xbox controller, but I'm kind of waiting for Xbox One controllers to have PC support before I drop like $50 to $60 on an expensive controller. Hey Galen, what's up? I wish devs would stop assuming people were using Xbox controllers. Yeah, it is kind of a pain in the ass. Especially for games that only support Xbox controllers. Like, Limbo had that problem. You can download, like, an Xbox controller emulator, but, I mean, really, I wish PC games had support for more controllers than that. Okay, so we're in kind of a little tutorial area here. Hold down and tap that to attack down. Okay, I will do that. Oh, okay. It's like a temporary platform. Can I hit torches? I keep thinking I can hit the torches. I can hit the chandeliers. That's very Castlevania, by the way. The way those chandeliers drop money like that. It looks very Castlevania-esque. Mindlessly destroying statues because I can. Oh, hey guy, what's up? Press X to attack. Well, I don't want to attack the king. He's just standing there. I guess I have to. Oh, okay. Alright, so let's see. That's the options button. Okay. That all looks good. Oh, wait. Run button. Alright. Oops, crap. Okay, that's credits. I guess that's what that scroll is. Well, at least the buttons are sort of mapped to the same positions they would be on the Xbox controller. Everything's recorded, Nixel. This will all be on YouTube after the stream's over. Might take a little bit of time for it to go up on YouTube. Alright, well, let's start our legacy. I have to say, right off the bat, I really love the way this game controls. Like, your character moves really quickly, the jump's nice and responsive. Everything feels pretty good so far. Oh, you know what? I haven't been doing the syncing the chat thing lately. I kind of forgot about it. Alright, well, we don't have any teleporters yet, so I guess I'll just teleport to the same location. You can view the map at any time by hitting that, okay? Oh, yes, that's the assassin we were controlling at the beginning of the game. And now the king's descendants are getting revenge for him. Alright, what's going on with this door? Okay, it looks like we have daggers we can use for 10 MP. Okay, that's the dagger button. Okay. Whoa. He made the downward thrust toggle from just pressing down in the options instead of having to press attack as well. That sounds pretty good. What was the options button? Oops. Oh, can I not get into the options from here? Oh wait, I have to pause it first. Enable quick drop. Drop down ledges and down attacks in air by pressing down. Okay. Oops, damn it. Wrong button. Alright, so now we just jump and press down. Okay. Yeah, that is better. Thanks for the suggestion. Ow. Oh shit. Yeah, like I said, this is the first time I've actually played the game. I've watched it, but well, I pressed down. I don't know why that didn't work. Alright, so yeah, like I said, first time I played this game. Alright, so what are our options here? Chickens freak you out. You can't see colors due to monochromacy. Press B to fire a dagger. Walking tank. That sounds good. Throws a giant axe. I like the sound of Sir Gans. Let's try him out. Don't trust the thrust. Oh. I'll keep that in mind. Wow, that's fast. We can already unlock that guy. I guess that was all of our gold. Okay. Alright, well, no gold, so I won't even bother looking at that stuff yet. Yeah, you gotta have all of my money. Every piece of money I have. Alright, let's see if we can last a little bit longer this time. Despite not being able to see color. Okay, same thing. Oh shit. I didn't press that. Wow, okay. I guess we're going to be taking a leap of faith here. Hopefully there's not spike stone on the bottom. Oh look, there's spike stone on the bottom. Jesus. I thought there was a chest or something. This guy looks like he's going to be a tough nut to crack. Oh, no, he wasn't that bad. Alright, well, we do have quite a few more hit points than last time. That's pretty good. Well, that's a pretty good bit of gold. Unfortunately, it's harder to tell how many hit points I have at a glance due to the color blindness. Oh, is that not an enemy? Guess not. Oh, spikes, great. See, you can't duck or anything. That kind of sucks. See, no way to kill those barrels like that. Oh my god, so many spikes. Okay. Alright, well, I got a good hit on him, but kind of bounced there. Alright. Baldness. Low stats, but can land devastating critical strikes. Hmm. You can't see in 3D. Okay. I like the barbarian. It's a pretty good bit of hit points. Okay, what can I unlock here? Mana up or health up? I think health up sounds like a pretty good investment. Turn your knights into paladins. I think more health sounds like a good investment. Wow, there's 75 of those? Jesus. Duke, what you drinking? Just water. Nothing fun for me tonight. Whoa, that's pretty cool. Oh yeah, I forgot I couldn't spend gold here as well. Oh, let's see. 250 to unlock. 150. Need a blueprint. 200. Okay. Well, hell, is there anything I can spend this last 50 on? No, I guess not. Oh, well. It'll get easier once you start getting used to the enemy tells. Yeah, I figured it was that sort of game. Alright. Oop. It would help if I remember which button was the attack button. It's a weird effect when... Oh, that must be... Oh, that's cool. Like, it kind of turns you into a Paper Mario sprite. That's interesting. That's a lot of spikes. I don't like the look of all those spikes. Shit. I should have just left that gold alone. I'm an idiot. Crap, are these all... No, those are just normal platforms, right? Yeah, okay. Oh! I should have known that would happen. Why didn't I know that would happen? It's like, oh, a perfectly normal looking painting. I'm sure that's not a trap. I'm assuming mana doesn't just automatically go up in this game. Blood chest plate? Okay. Oh, is the stream stuttering? That sucks. Is it bad for everyone? My settings should be... It should be fine. I'm playing in 1280 by 720 at 30 FPS, which is what I normally stream at. Oh, you're refreshing. It's fine. Okay. Must just be something on Twitch's end. Another teleporter. Nice. Can actually come back here. Not really any reason to do that right now. Unless I want to, Oh, okay, that's an open chest. Well, let's see, I can go up in the middle there, or I can go down where that teleporter is. I think I want to go down. Oh god. Oh god. Oh wow. That's a lot of stuff. Let's see. Can't. I tried to cast my big sword, but I couldn't. Well, damn. Alright, a barbarian who's afraid of chickens. Insensitivity to pain. Is that good or bad? And B throws a chakram, which comes back to you. That's kind of cool. So it's a grand blade. You're very talented with a few issues. IBS. Oh my god. Well, if I'm Lady Fae and I upgrade my knights to paladins, that might be beneficial to me. Press Y to block all incoming damage. That sounds pretty good. Can't level that up, can't level that up. Okay. And I won't be able to upgrade anything here, right? But I can. Okay, yeah, it shows you then what's new with the blueprints you picked up. You shouldn't explore the different regions yet unless you're suicidal. Well, I didn't know that was going to lead to a different region. Is there a way to tell when an exit goes to a different region? Because it just looks like part of the map to me. Alright. There's Y to block. Oh. That's cool. Oh. Oh, I guess that was the dungeon. Oh, they always have a teleport. Right before the area switches. Okay. That's good to know. Thank you. So is being able to block the only benefit to leveling up to paladin? Looks like it. Really love like the look of this game. Like it's retro without being too twee about it. Music's good, controls are good. Yeah, I waited way too long to get this game. Shit. But that has been rectified. Oh, it cost MP to block magic? Or does it cost MP to block everything? Shit. MP for the first hit, everything else is free. Oh, okay. That is also good to know. Damn, that's a lot of gold. Jesus Christ. So what happens if you don't have the MP? Do you just take the damage? I'm assuming that's the case. Ah, hell. Thought I was doing okay there. Oh, was that a block? Was that a boss fight? Hmm. Knave. Yeah. Paladin. Pretty good at everything. Anything far away is blurry. Summoning Grand Blade. Ooh, mage. Every kill gives you mana. Break stuff to restore MP. That sounds pretty good. Oh. It's the descendant of this guy somehow. Okay. Yeah, sure. That wasn't a boss fight. Oh, okay. The tougher the enemy, the bigger it gets. Gotcha. Well, let's see. I think I want to save my gold and get something, get that better armor from the blacksmith. Oops. Okay, now I'm going to save my gold. Because I hit the wrong button. Well, I can't buy the armor now. That sucks. I can get the helmet. Or do I not have the blueprints for that? Looks like it's grayed out. Okay, yeah, I can pick it up. Alright, I'm going ahead and get that. 200, no blueprints. Alright. It's great because you didn't buy it. Okay. Didn't look like something that would be available. So can I, like, see my stat? Yeah. Well, that doesn't show me my, Oh, wrong button. Oh, here we go. Wow. That is, like, a straight-up magic card layout for that. That's interesting. Every kill gives you 6 mana break stuff to restore MP. Okay. And if you decide you'd rather have a castle upgrade, you can always go left again. Yeah, that's true. I love that it actually gives you a reason to break stuff now. Alright, see what this axe does once we get another enemy. Wow, this is kind of brutal. Okay, yeah, that is a straight up Castlevania axe. A lot of Castlevania influences in this game, it seems, but you know, that's a good thing. Castlevania is pretty cool. That's quite a bit of damage, too. There's a painting behind the bad painting. Shit! Oh, I love that run animation. Hey, what's up, Radigan Conniger? Good to see you. Ow. Oh. Health is a very important stat to raise. Sir Kotaki's 2 parting words. Alright, Barbarian, no knockback, throw a chakram. Sounds good. Chakram, OCD, Barbarian. You remember things with extreme clarity. Huh. Well, let's see what that does. Alright, I think getting more health is probably a good idea. I can get equip up as well, since I don't think there's anything I can buy from that guy. Oh, that unlocks more stuff. Unlock the architect and gain the power to lock down the castle. Gain access to magical runes and powers. Right. Remember enemy placement. Oh, okay. Alright, let's dive some more. Definitely a lot of this game is very heavily focused on the on the character development. Like, there's a lot more, you get a lot more stuff just for playing a little bit and dying than you do in most roguelikes. Which is fine. Oof. I mean, since the game isn't, it's not technically a roguelike. It's an action roguelike or a roguelike-like or whatever you want to call it. I call it a rogue thing. I can't look down, can I? Probably not. Oh, there's two of those things. No wonder the projectile placement is so erratic. Okay, that's just... I can't fire that up or anything. I can do that, though. Shit. These things have a lot of hit points. Oh, that was pretty good. Blood bracers. Oh, that was a mini boss? Okay. Oh boy, getting out of here is going to be fun. Wow. Your sword kind of, when you do the down slash, does not stay in that position for very long. You kind of have to do it right as you are on top of those things. But you can't wait too long. Shit! Alright. There's no way to heal myself or anything, is there? Other than just picking up items. I mean, I can't, like, go back to the teleporter and heal up or anything, can I? That would probably be too generous of it. The down thrust is very brief, yeah. Okay. Oh, no, don't do that. Why would you do that? You don't get anything from that. Oh boy. Aw, zombie doesn't trigger the spikes? What a ripoff. Can I stand on that? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, Jesus. Well, that was a net loss. Great. Shit. You gotta find some chicken, yeah. I've come to that conclusion. Alright. Paladin, Savant, Scythe. Gigantism. Nice. I don't know if Gigantism is probably bad. Makes you a bigger target. So I will go with the stereo blind guy. Who can use scythes. Alright, 480. Not enough to get the big armor upgrade. So I will just get a health boost, I guess. Let's see. Can I buy anything for 240? I think I can get something with that. No, I guess not. Oh, I can get those. Plus one vampirism, nice. Should probably just save up and get those. Because, I mean, once I unlock these, I'm never going to use these, right? Oh, wait. That decreases your health. That might not be so good. Alright, I'll go with those. I mean, I'm going to lose my gold here anyway, so I guess I might as well buy something, right? Gigantism also gives greater range, so it's like a trade-off. Alright. Let's kick off some ass. Some non-3D ass. Ow. Gotta remember I can block now. Oh, wait. Okay. So I don't actually have to be facing the direction of the thing I'm blocking. That's nice. I like how some of the paintings are just normal paintings. So you're paranoid of all the paintings. Regardless of whether it's death time or not. That's nice that my sword can go through the walls a little bit. Never gonna get that money though. Does that just stay there forever or does it disappear eventually? Looks like it just stays there. That's cool. Kinda sucks that I'll never be able to get to that stuff though. Well, wait a second, how am I supposed to get to that chest then? There's gotta be a secret or something, right? That section of wall looks a little bit different than the rest of the section of wall. Huh. Can I, Nope, that doesn't do anything. Curious. Oh, you have to be small, okay. Well, okay, I guess there are probably other advantages to being gigantic then. Things that you can only get if you're the proper size. If I was tiny, I could probably jump through that as well. And fall down through. Well, that actually. That looks big enough. But I guess not. Alright. I can keep going up here. Fairy chest objective, take no damage. Oh, so I have to take no damage in this room? Kinda wish that would go away. Get off the screen. You're in my way! Message? Oh. Oh. Wow. I do not know if I will be able to do that. I will try. I will probably die. Alright. Wish me luck, I guess. Ah, you suck. Oh, crap. Oh, I can just drop down. I can't try that again, can I? No. Sigh. Oh, well. At least I'm still alive. Oh shit, that guy is big. Oh my god. That guy is fast. That guy is big and fast. Sir Skunky has been slain by Botus. Press back to open the map. Sir Skunky's parting words. Alright, Mage, Paladin. Your MP and HP pools are swapped. Whoa. But you can't cast spells properly. Those two traits probably don't go that well together. Let's go with the Barbarian. 320 gold. Meh. Guess I can go ahead and get that guy. get the power to lock down the castle. So I guess if I wanted to go back and get that chest that I couldn't get before, then I could lock down the castle. I mean, if I had a small person, I could lock down the castle and go get that chest. Ooh, attack up. Costs exactly 190 gold. Looks like a sign to me. Want to know a cool fact? I'm crazy. Take 40% of all the gold you earn. Wow, that sucks. Nah, I'm good. Okay, so I'm not the paladin now. Gotta remember that I cannot block. Not that I was blocking much in the last playthrough. Should probably leave that stuff there until I'm hurt. Just in case it's wall meat. How the hell am I supposed to do this? I don't think I can even jump without hitting those spikes up there. Is there like a double jump or something? So I can like drop down and then double jump up onto that pillar. Oops. Well, that's not going to help. Need double jump, says Radigan. Yes. I guess that is the case. I'm not going to come back here. Might as well just smash this stuff. Oh god, that spikes. Can I stand on that barrel? Yeah. Probably not a very good place to stand though. Oh god, I am so dead. Wait. Why does my sub-weapon keep changing? Is that one of my traits? Oh, randomized spell. Oh, that's what Savant does. Okay. Well, good to know. Nope. Oh boy, that guy's big. Oh my god. Okay, so these guys aren't gonna charge, they're just gonna slash if I get too close. Wish I had some MP. Alright, there's a chest over here if I can... Oh, there's no exit that direction now. Wow, did not seem like a lot of MP. Compared to the rest of my bar there. That's a big sword. Well, hell. I'd like to get that chest. Oh wait, no, that was that one room where I need the double jump. Never mind. Okay. Am I hitting the chest to open them or to test if they're mimics? Well, I mean, I'm kind of used to Spelunky where you hit chests to open them. But if there's mimics in this game, then it might not be a bad idea. Slain by a Doomvus. If you fail a fairy chest room, the architect can give you a second chance. Oh, that's good to know. Alright, mage, barbarian, gigantism. I kind of don't want to see what IBS does. Oh, well, let's go with the big dude. I have 350 gold. Upgrade barbarian. Not enough for that. Enchantress. Gain access to her magical runes and powers. Sounds like that could be useful. Upgrade mage, magic damage up. Can't afford either of those yet. I can upgrade the amount I can equip. Well, let's see if I can buy anything from this guy first. I don't think so. Or I could try to buy something from the magic user. Oh, I have to find the runes? I guess you start out with a couple. So are the runes, like, attached to the equipment or something? Well, that's a double jump. I think that would be a useful one to unlock. God, look at how huge I am. That's ridiculous. And the runes, apparently they just stay on you, according to Bippo. Alright. I'm a fucking beast. I'm gonna show this castle what's what. Don't do more damage, sadly. I like how I can just barely fit through the doors now. It is a little easier to hit stuff, though, now that I have a giant weapon. Nice. See, now that I'm gigantic, I can just stand there and swipe at those guys. Would have been more difficult to hit them if I was normal sized. Well, maybe. I don't know. Aw, man, I should have locked that castle down so I could get that fairy chest with the double jump. Of course, now that I'm huge, the double jump probably wouldn't have helped me. Oh yeah, there's fireballs there. There's fireballs there too. And more fireballs. Should upgrade the barbarian next. Maybe. Depends on how much money I have. After this run, take no damage. I can probably pull this off. Oof. I don't know. Oh. Ah, damn, so close. I was distracted by the farting. I might lock this castle down and try that again. There's definitely not much in the way of health in this game. Couldn't switch back to the axe even if I wanted to, no. Did that hit me if I walk through it? Doesn't look like it. No, okay. I don't like how some of the enemy's projectiles go through the walls and some of them don't. Oop, that didn't work. That didn't work. Wish I could hold up and slash my sword in that direction. Oh, sweet. Got a few hit points. Not many, but better than nothing. Oh god. Oh man. I don't really want to attempt this with how few hit points I have. Apparently Steam decided to ignore my command to pause updates. Hate it when that happens. That was worth a shot. Alright, mage, barbarian, mage. You are a fan of the man. Ooh, that doesn't sound good. I think I'll be this guy. He doesn't have the nearsighted. Not sure if I'm a big fan of the mages yet, though. All right, 330. A telephobia. What's that? Choose a hero with no traits. Oh, I see. And open your first gold chest. Okay. Well, let's see. Magic damage up. That's probably a good idea, considering I'm the mage. Actually, I think more health is another good idea. Run button. Alright, you still don't have anything for me, right? Well, just all of a sudden. Now see, can I, is that still equipped? I guess it is. That's pretty cool, but I just always have that. Okay, I want this castle to be the same, because I want to get that fairy chest that I missed. I'm pretty sure I can do that this time. Whenever you transition to another area, the room will always house a teleport pad, a health pickup, and a magic pickup. Oh, that's good to know. Is my map still there? Oh yeah, that's cool. Alright. Oh yeah, I remember this room. This room sucks. Oh wow. The scythe is okay. Wow, I don't have any hit points, so I'm gonna have to be careful. I say as I immediately walk directly into a zombie, because I was looking at something else on the screen. Nice! I'm already down to 23 hit points. Jesus Christ. Oh, come on, are you going to spawn or not, you stupid zombie? Oh. Apparently one hit wasn't enough to kill that zombie. Alright, let's try that again. Your permaroided attacks knock enemies further. Wow, that sounds pretty good. I don't know what hypochondriac does. And I didn't get any money for that since I died so quickly. And they took 40% of it. At least the fee from the architect doesn't stack. Yeah, that's good. Alright, let's try this one more time. Kind of disappointing that I haven't gotten out of this first area yet, except right at the beginning. And when I did, it was a very bad idea. So I'm assuming these chests don't refill. Yeah, okay. Just wanted to double check that. Alright, if I can get through this first room over here, I should be able to do okay. Oh yeah, I'm referring to hypochondriac. Exaggerate the damage you take. Ooh. That sounds pretty bad, actually. A knockback is pretty fun, though. Makes it a little bit harder to hit stuff. Oh, yeah. For some reason, I thought I had the dagger. Shit. This is probably not going to be a very long playthrough since I have that hypochondriac trait. Well, I don't know. It didn't seem to do that much more damage to me. Shit. Oh, it did damage twice. Shit. At least my magic has the same knockback trait. Ah, crap. Thought I could make it. Alright. Let's do this shit. Fudge! Oh well. Oh, it's not actually doing the damage. It's just cosmetic. Oh, okay. That's kind of funny, actually. It was a little frightening at first, but, aw, what? I downslashed that thing. You jack. Oh, okay. That's what that question mark refers to. It's a different weapon I could pick up. Damn, I can't believe I missed that fairy chest again. Did that thing take damage from walking into the spikes? Oh. So did I. I thought I could walk through those. I did last time, it feels like. Oh well. Kind of feel bad about giving up 60% of my, or 40% of my gold now. Oh well. Oh, another fairy chest. Interesting. Take no damage. Oh boy. Okay. Well, that one on the outside, it looks like I can just walk under. Easier said than done. Nope. I should have just gone back, but I wanted to see what would happen if I kept going forward. Challenge sucks unless you have time stop. Yeah, the ability to stop time would definitely be helpful there. Coprolalia. I don't want to be a knave, though. Oh, he has Coprolalia, too. Excellent. Or she, I should say. I'm sorry. Alright, yeah, I'm not going to go back for that fairy chest. The gold penalty just sucks too much. I don't think I can afford anything now. Which is 120. Still don't have any of these, whatever they are. Looks like a cape. You should always go for chests, honestly. Well, I mean, I'm sure I'll get more chests in subsequent playthroughs. Armor upgrades or runes are almost always found in them. Yeah, but I'm worried I'll fuck it up again. Alright, I'll go for it one more time. If I don't get the fairy chest this time, then I'm just going to do a couple more standard playthroughs, then I'm done. Because, you know, it's boring seeing the same thing over and over again in the stream. Alright, what is this? Oh, wow. Nice. Oh wow, those things are still going. That was pretty good. Fuck! Can't believe I didn't see that zombie again. For God's sake. I like those orbs. They last a long time. Oh wow, I actually killed that thing in one hit that time. That's cool. Alright, see you later, Nyx. Thanks for coming. Alright. I can do this, damn it. Alright. Siphon rune. Bracers. Oh, interesting. Alright. Glad I gave that another shot. That's probably going to be useful. I'm probably not going to get that other chest though. Not without any special runes or anything. That really seemed kind of impossible. You should avoid the orbs after you've thrown them to give them as much time to cause damage as possible, since touching them makes them disappear. Oh, okay. I didn't know that. I guess I can try to get that other chest. I really don't think I'll be able to, but... I mean, it's there. Ooh. Wish I could get that. Fuck. God damn it. Oh well. Alright. Okay, we're going the right way. Alright. That doesn't go... No. Okay. Oh well. Objective failed, yeah. That's a bummer. Alright, unexplored territory. Let's go. Not even worth trying, yeah. It probably wasn't. Oh god. These are a lot of projectiles that can go through walls. Do enemies respawn? No, I guess they don't. Oh wow. Okay, forwards and backwards. This should be doable. Ah, hell. Premature jump. Fuck! Lady Shinoa 2's parting words. Alright, let's do a normal playthrough. Dementia, you are insane. Wait, does she have gigantism too? She looks bigger than the other ones, but doesn't say she has gigantism. Just the knockback and the heaviness. Let's go for it. I still don't have enough to... I can get my equipment up. I can get my magic damage up. Don't have enough to upgrade Barbarian. Alright. See if there's any runes or anything I can buy. Probably not. $350, $500. Oh, endomorphism at size. Okay. $350. Alright, well there was something back here I could get, wasn't there? Mana? Yeah, I mean, I might as well, since we're going to lose that money anyway. Alright, let's give it a couple more goes here. I really like this game. Having a lot of fun with this so far. Oh, you can get endomorphism and gigantism at the same time? That sounds pleasant. Ah, hell. Let's see, what do I have? The chakra? That's just straight ahead, right? Yeah. Can't forget about my double jump. That'd be helpful in situations like these. Oh, of course, is it fucking evil painting. Damn it. Oh, I can't get in there? Is there a secret I'm missing or something? Ow. Ow. Boy, that doesn't go very far, does it? It's probably good if you can get a hit with it on the boss, since it kind of hovers there for a second. Ow, you asshole. Oh, you can jump over the chakra? Yeah, that's interesting. Oh, is that a boss room? Yep, health and mana. It is probably a boss room. Don't know if I'm actually ready for that yet. This is another area? Jesus. Oh, goes to the same place. That makes sense. The Maya. Well, I guess I'm about as ready to fight a boss as I'll ever get. What do you guys think? Should I try? Or should I explore some more? Think I'm ready for this? Keter. Oh wow, it's bullet hell boss. Guess I should have anticipated that. Right, you can't just hit the eye, you have to hit the iris. Nope. Give it a look. I see what you did there. Alright. 10 o'clock. I've been at this for 3 hours. Let's go one more and then call it a night. Paladin colorblind blade wall. Alzheimer's. Peripheral artery disease. Wow. Let's go with the pally. Alright. I actually have enough money to buy something useful now. I mean, I've already upgraded the paladin, so no point in upgrading the barbarian or the mage in this playthrough. I think I'm going to get that good armor. Oh yeah, I'm colorblind. Damn. Oh yeah, that's not good for your health. Damn it. Let's see, I can buy that and just get 9 armor, I guess. Really don't want to have to take a hit. Wait, did I buy that? Yep, I guess I did. Oh well. Hit the wrong button. Is that equipped? Doesn't have the little E logo on it. Oh. Oh, I can't carry it. I don't have enough, I can unequip stuff, I guess. Well, that's already lowering my health. Oh, but that takes weight away. That takes weight away as well, but it lowers my magic. Oh, I see. I wasn't even really paying attention to these stats. Hey, what's up, 3Jack? Well, that sucks. I bought armor that I can't even use unless I unequip my sword. I mean, vampirism might be useful, so I guess let's give it a try. Oh, great start. Walk right into a zombie. Am I absorbing health from enemies? Sure looks like it. I mean, that's what I figured, Vim. Yep, plus 2 HP. Okay. Well, that might actually be worth the trade for the sword. Alright, that's just a normal... That's just a normal turret. That's just a normal knight, right? Yeah, looks like it. Ah, hell. Ah. Well, I am liking vampirism quite a bit. 2 HP from every enemy you kill seems like a pretty big deal. You know, you wouldn't think it would make that much of a difference, but I feel like being colorblind does make it a little bit harder. I mean, you don't really need color for that much of the game, but like, I don't know, it's distracting. I'm not really sure why. At least my map's still in color. That's a relief. Vampirism is arguably the best bonus. Yeah, I am... I like how the Wordle kind of goes in color while you're in the map, too. So, like, if you want to see what color something is, you can just pop into the map. Wonder if it's supposed to do that. Of course, I'm taking a lot of damage. So, 2 hit points here and there isn't going to make a huge difference, but it's definitely nice. The hell? Oh. Story. So level with me. Are there mimics in this game? Is that something I'm going to have to watch out for? Because, I mean, you mentioned it, so figured I should ask. In later areas, okay. Good to know. I'm the kind of person who checks his map compulsively in these kind of games, by the way. Don't mind me. I always want to make sure there aren't any additional exits in the area where I am. and make sure there aren't any items or anything that I'm missing that would show up on the map. Really don't like games that don't have a map. That's why I'm kind of hesitant to try out Dark Souls. I have it. It's been sitting in my Steam library for a while now. But, I'm just worried I'm going to have absolutely no idea where I'm supposed to go in that game without a map to kind of point me in the right direction. I mean, I know the point of that game is, the exploration, and that's what makes it fun and everything. But, if you have a map, you can still explore. You just know you're not going to get lost if you need to find your way back to, if I'm playing Dark Souls and I want to find my way back to a bonfire or something, I want to know that I'm going to have that option. And, I'm good with super hard games. I mean, this game is pretty tough, but I'm having fun with it. But, not having a map, that's the kind of difficulty that I don't like. I don't know. Maybe I'm just a wuss. Hey, what's up, Sore Thumb? And Triangulate 3, what's going on? I mean, Dark Souls looks like a really fun game, though. I mean, I've been watching Vinny's playthrough of the game on Giant Bomb. And it's definitely fun to watch, but I don't know, I don't think it's the kind of game for me. So is there ever a reason to teleport back to the start? I mean, it's weird that it gives you that option when it doesn't really seem like you would gain that much from it. Jesus Christ. I don't know what I was supposed to do there. Sort of much later in the game. Alright, let's go one more since Sore Thumb just showed up and I wouldn't want to disappoint him. Ooh. Time stop. That sounds useful. But he also has no peripheral vision. Dwarfism. Oh, wow. They actually do the thing where the female dwarves have beards. That's awesome. Oh, yeah, okay. Well, I don't know. I kind of want to try that time stop. But then no peripheral vision sounds like it would not be enjoyable. Decisions. Let's go with the dwarf. Wait. She's not a dwarf, but she still has a beard. Oh well, maybe she's a dwarf in spirit. Tunnel vision isn't usually too bad. Yeah. Oh wow, I have a lot of money. Sweet. Okay. Well, I definitely want to hang on to the vampirism. See, what am I? I'm a mage, right? Transform them into the powerful archmage. Press Y to switch spells. Alright, well let's oops. I actually didn't mean to do that. Let's see what kind of equipment I can get first. Still the only sword that's available. Wait. I can equip that now? Oh, do the different characters have different, carrying capacity or something? Because I didn't upgrade that. I upgraded my mana, right? I guess I could upgrade my carrying capacity, though, so I can equip those bracers. By weight, says Kasha. Oh, all mages have beards. Okay. Plus 10 to weight. Yeah, that actually sounds like a pretty good idea. So now I can equip those. Can't afford to unlock those. Alright, still don't have any of that. Have my vampirism, have my helmet, have my sword. Okay. Looks like I'm good to go on equipment. What about runes? Sprint. Gain the power to dash short distances. Steal mana from slain enemies. Oh, is that like a passive? That sounds pretty good, actually. Alright. Well, as good as that sounds, I think... I should probably put some more points into my attack, actually. It's a mana equivalent of Vampirism. Yeah, that's nice that that's a rune that you can just equip and always have. Yeah, I think I'm going to go for more attack. And then I have 145. Don't believe there's anything I can get with that. Kind of sad to waste that money, but what can you do? Well, look at how tiny she is. Alright, so what do I have? The chakram? Okay. Oh, well, I guess this is the reason you want to teleport back to the beginning. This is like the ultimate boss room, right? I kind of forgot about that. Wait, did I get mana for killing that? I didn't buy that rune, did I? Or is that just the passive ability that the mage has or something? Oops. Oh yeah, every kill gives you 6 mana. Okay. I guess that's a mage thing. Okay. Eventually I'll learn the buttons for this game. Runes have a global price. It goes up with which rune you buy. Oh, okay. Ow. It does kind of suck having such a tiny attack, I have to say. I mean, it's cool that I can get into tiny areas, but it's definitely a drawback. Yeah, I guess since I'm a mage, I should be using my magic more, huh? Because it costs 15 to cast that. Oh god. And I get 6 back with every kill. And I just took a fuck ton of damage there. Good god. Well, I guess I do only have 70 hit points. Defeat all enemies? Really? But I can't. Well, I can do that, I guess. I can't hit anything else with my chakram, though. Well, maybe there are other spells I can get that'll help me out. Do those come back? No. Throwing axes probably could. Yeah, probably. Let's see if I unlock that that mage power up. Then I could probably have the ability to switch between two spells. It looks like that's what that did. Alright. Yeah, let's keep going. Why not? I don't work tomorrow. Well, I haven't met anyone with ADHD yet, so let's try that out. 350. Can I get the barbarian? No, I can't. That sucks. Alright, let's see if there's any, Oh, wow. It's pretty fast. Yeah, definitely want to keep that vampirism armor. That's pretty good. See, that costs 500. I guess I can go on ahead and get one of these other runes. Siphon mana. I wonder if that stacks with the mage ability. I figure it probably does. Alright, see you later, Costs. Thanks for coming out. I just tried to look you up on my Ouya. Wait, the stream's still going, right? It says it's still going. Huh. Well, I blame the Ouya, personally. Stream is good. Okay. Aw, man. I should have just left that. I should just leave the stuff here and teleport. Teleport back there when I'm low on health or something. Because I totally just wasted that wall turkey. I mean, it wasn't in a wall, technically. But it still counts as a wall turkey for the purposes of video games. Oh, being fast is kind of nice. Damn, wasted another wall turkey. That's a pretty good amount of gold. You can't just hold down and continually drop through platforms. Okay, so with the mana leech thing, you get 2 MP for every enemy you kill. Which still isn't bad. Oh, all tunnel vision does is make it so you can't see those off-screen projectile warnings, says Bippa. Fudge! Well, let's see. Let's head back and go down before I get too far ahead. I have to say, more speed where you have this degree of control over your character is definitely a good thing. Yeah, it seems like I'm finding a lot of wall turkey in this game. Is that like a trade or something? You find more food? No. Just getting lucky, I guess. And we're finding a lot of mana potions, too. I mean, I'm not complaining. Just wonder to what I owe my good fortune. Feeling pretty good about this playthrough so far. Ah, what? I totally killed that eye. hard to keep a repeated bounce going. Like, when you once you bounce once, see? I guess it would be pretty easy to cheese it if they made it easy to do that. Oh my god, I'm taking way too much damage. My good fortune has reversed. The castle of KFC, says Bippo. Yeah, sure looks that way. Now that stuff doesn't stay the same if you keep the castle the same, right? The power-ups and stuff. I'm assuming all that stuff is still randomized. Because this one might be a nice one to come back to. Considering how generous it was being. Oh, more story. Ah, fuck. The bookshelf messed me up. The drops from breakables always stay random. Yeah, that's what I figured. Wow, nothing up here? It's kind of disappointing. The down thrust isn't usually worth the trouble to try doing combos with since it only does half damage. Yeah, looks that way. Sometimes, though, when you have those spike fields, the down thrust seems like it might be the best way to take out some of those enemies. I don't know, maybe not. Is this a challenge room or just a really dickish room? Looks like a really dickish room. And I'm out of mana. Great. Damn. Alright, one more. That'll be a 3.5 hour stream. That's probably more than enough. Weak limbs. That's another ADHD, dude. I should probably try out this quantum translocator thing. Challenge rooms always have the pop-up. Yeah, that's what I thought. Aw, man, it's a nave, though. That sucks. Enemies won't get knocked back. Well, I guess I should at least try the nave. And try the teleport. Since I haven't really done either of those. Naves do good crit damage, yeah. Don't know if it'll be worth it, but I'll try. Alright, if I get this... Alright, I can get more health and more... be able to carry stuff. And use all of my gold. Oh, wait. Oh, the cost of that went up when I bought more health. Okay. Oh, what can I get with 290? Anything? I can get more magic damage. See if I have any, what the hell is that? Oi. I don't know what trait is causing that black smoke to billow out from me. That's not a side effect of baldness, is it? Alright, Nope. Are these better than what I'm using? Is it really? I don't really think so. But they do add more vampirism too. Alright, well, what about runes? Can I buy a rune? Nope. I figure all this stuff is going to cost about the... Well, there's only the one. Okay, let's buy the magic damage up then, since I can actually afford that. Oh, the dark mist is just the knave's cosmetic effect. Okay. Alright, Charon. The loading screen said balding. That's pretty good. Alright. Well, I guess this stuff does stay here, right? Does it stay here if I leave the room? No, I guess not. See, I want to get that stuff just in case it's gold. But if it's power-ups... Like, I totally wasted that mana potion. Do you ever get critical hits on the down slash? That might actually be pretty good. I mean, the critical hits themselves look pretty good too. Just the normal crits. All physical attacks get crits, nice. Yeah, crits seem to be popping up pretty frequently, too. More frequently than I thought they would, anyway. Jesus! God, that's a lot of enemies. And I'm already almost dead. Great. That's a downside to saying just one more run with this game. Because now, I feel like this was a terrible run, and I want to play again. Alright, how does this teleport work? Right, so you pay 5 to leave your shadow there, then 5 to teleport back to it? Oh, okay. The knave has 35% crit chance. That's pretty good. I mean, I'd be doing okay if I didn't get surrounded by those little mage assholes. Man, that teleport would have been really useful for a couple of those fairy rooms. Do they, like, disable the teleport in those rooms or something? Oh, teleporting back to it is free? Nice. Oh, wait, no. It wouldn't be useful for those rooms because you can't make a teleport spot. Okay, never mind. I'm dumb. Whoa. That is... I mean, it looks like a boss from a bullet hell game. I wonder if it's trying to tell me something. You can read it for DevMet messages. Really? How? Oh! You stand in front of it. Bullet Odyssey. Development time 3.5 months. Oh, is this one of their previous games or something? Yep, I guess so. Whoa. That sounds kind of cool. Wow, that game sounds kind of interesting. A rhythm-based bullet hell shooter. I might have to look that game up. I mean, I'm sure I would suck at it, but... sounds like something I'd at least want to check out. Are there like secret passages or doors or anything in this game? Because I feel, in a game like this, I feel, you know, like I'm not doing my due diligence if I'm not like hitting every wall to see if there are secrets. Wow, that jerky didn't give me very many hit points. Ah, hell. Some walls have secret passages, but never breakable. Interesting. Is this going to be a boss? Nope, just a different area. Okay. Well, let's see. I guess I can go ahead and teleport back and go in that exit down there that I haven't done. Not sure about the nave. The crits are definitely nice. Thought I could stand on these. I was standing on them before, wasn't I? Damn it! That's one way to do it. Just keep leaving and coming back until you get a crit. So yeah, the teleport seems cool, but possibly limited in the situations it's useful. Oh, I was standing on a table behind the turret. Whoa! Are you a good guy? 25% of my current gold, I will give you a chance to open one of three chests. Oh. Well, what the hell? I'm here. Alright, this one. Well, geez, you don't have to rub it in my face. Come on, best 2 out of 3. No? Okay. Damn, I was hoping you would fall for that. Buttons! Oh well, it was only 200 gold. There are worse things I could have spent the money on. Aw, man, I should have made a teleport point back there. Oh well. Defeat all enemies. So it doesn't matter if I get hit or not, right? Just gotta kill everything. Well, this seems doable, even though I only have 9 hit points. Fuck. I saw it coming. It's usually worth the 25% for a chance to get triple that. Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I'll probably do that every time that comes up. That option. Alright, well. Should at least spend some of this money, I guess. Before I end the stream. What do I have? 750? That's pretty good. I should get that barbarian upgrade. Barbarian kings. Learn the secret shout of the bears and shout at things until they explode. Pharodus. Alright, well. Bippo suggested that I upgrade the barbarian. So 270. What about you? Have anything good for sale? Not that I can afford. I bet. Yeah. Okay, well, this has been a pretty good stream, I think. Thanks everyone for watching. Do this again sometime soon. It was a lot of fun. And, hope you had a blast. I know I did. Alright. Talk to all of you later. Good night.